Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Today, we've got a good Week 5 matchup in store here between the New York Giants and the Green Bay Packers. Season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in Week 5 on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Forward for about three at second down.
So this matchup, the second of three games in London this year. Vikings and Saints were here last week, and then the Broncos and Jags, they'll be at Wembley at the end of the month. Plus this year, remember, a fourth European game, our first one ever in Munich, Germany. That'll be the Bucs and the Seahawks, November 13th.
Second and seven. Rodgers into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked by Julian Love. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
A first down carry for Barkley. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Again with Barkley. It'll be a gain of five, and it's going to bring up a third and about seven left.
Those defense for the Packers, they were strong last week, CD, in that win over New England.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. Five sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in, and run the ball?
And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down.
Quay Walker,
able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So that, another sack for the first-round pick on the season. You know, he's shown here, Charles, in the first few months of his career that pass rushing, it might be a specialty of his.
Yeah, and I'm not sure that I graded him that way prior to the season. That's not necessarily what they drafted him for at all, but let's face it, they're going to take it, and I think they'll expand upon these talents that they found and keep sending him back to the quarterback.
Wow, I mean, it's so rare to even see one attempted from that distance, CD, let alone converted, but he came through with confidence and matches what was Tom Dempsey's 43-year NFL record at one point of 63 yards.
Yeah, I can still see that highlight of Dempsey making that kick, and nowadays we see it a little bit differently because, remember, Dempsey was a straight-on kicker. But these guys nowadays, the range keeps increasing, and they keep putting it through the posts.
What league are you talking about? You're winning 30-7. Yeah, I get to play Prince. Hope someone does that with me.
The left side, usually the technical side. That reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010.
second and four. The Packers had 2-2 through the first 4 weeks of the season. They're feeling pretty good after back-to-back victory, CD.
He's in here somewhere.
He is not gonna get in here as they push him back to the 2-yard line. That's gonna go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense. Countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. Romeo Doubs with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Packers have answered that early field goal to take a first quarter lead. And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here on the follow through. So they'll go ahead and accept the penalty. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Jones fakes the give to Barkley.
Oh my God, I had like a wide open hole to run like 30 yards with Jones and I fucking held the turbo button. Yep, ran right into all my tackles. I had an easy 25, 30 yards. Oh, come on, his knee was down.
Talk
Jones again on second down. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. Coming up here looking for three. To pick up the first. Rogers going to try and throw on third down. Got a man. It's sure it's complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to
play. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. And the Giants are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. A nightmare of a first half for him. That's now three interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I agree, because you don't get one of the best quarterbacks in the league without developing some major mental toughness. So I expect him to go to the locker room at halftime, hit the reset button, and come out a new guy in half number two.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, something you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. Throwing Jones. The throw for Tony is intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And the Packers are going to take over at their own 41. It's almost like you can see the look of frustration on his face. 4 interceptions last week. We talked about it all week. What did he do wrong? And another one here in the first half.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit. But the worst thing he can do is what you're saying right now. Showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got to gather himself, compose himself, and keep fighting.
They talked a lot about erasing that loss last week, getting back in the win column. We'll see how much. Run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Rodgers gonna throw. And he will find his man short. That's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A first down there on a pickup of 25. And defensively, they were in zone covers there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing play against a good quarterback like he is. To not play too much zone.
Yeah, you have to be careful about which time you're giving up. I mean, that's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Shotgun man for Rodgers. Slant route, he's got Dobbs. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Well, that's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. It doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary. Figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
Let's go. Back to the former Georgia Bulldog, Aziz Ojemari getting in there to bring him down. So now on 4th down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. This one from 46 yards out. The kick by Crosby is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Puts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Still the first half, but this offense has struggled. Not ahead of them to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better here on this drive.
result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that in our corner, see their job is simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
To throw again on second down. Jones trying to lay one up deep. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down.
Oh, good for all things.
Andrew Thomas, former first rounder from Georgia, calling for the penalty there.
So, yeah.
Now they face a second and long foul.
Not looking good this year, boys. Not looking good this year. We might have to go back to Madden 21 here. Who is that?
Last time for three. They got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for the field. They're hoping for touchdown.
I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead.
Hey, have you seen my other dips? Can you grab it for me? Can you get my gift for me real quick? Yeah. I always buy two. I leave one here and leave one in my truck. Yeah, I'm a motherfucking gangster. Yeah, a gangster losing and fucking Madden. Did she? What? That's cool. Too much? Really? The what?
The rowing machine. Get through your backpack, I guess.
Probably 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Sounds like you guys got it all figured out.
Working with a second and three.
I guess I'm not proud of me for getting up on the gym every morning.
Why would I be proud of you? I got to go to work. So went to work and busted down two walls for 2 hours. Oh, come on, man. These fucking cornerbacks is jump routes, bro. I don't know what to throw anymore. Can't just go sleeping in Anthony's bed.
Looking like it's going to be even more of a runaway
everybody gets a chance to play and get a little bit of love. The more guys I get to watch the highlight reels from this one, the better.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Back to throw. Jones will get this complete to Kadarius Toney. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll make it second down. Looking to throw. Jones, his throw incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
That is brought down short. 2 yards there, needed 4. And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. Off play action. Jones. He's going to float this one deep right side. And now here's another interception. Adrian Amos with a pick.
Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, 5 interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough. But, man, this defense, they have been ball-hawking and impressive. But, Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard. But also, you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game. So you have to know your player. You have to know the situation.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. Taking in at the 3. Offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. That's try to come back from a 4-possession deficit.
Well, partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think.
And my goodness, another interception. Adrian Amos with a pick, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
I see you reaching for the white flag. Put it down. I don't want you throwing it, but I understand why, because if you do, you're hoping they might actually stop this game, because we're in blowout territory right now. That interception just surrendered any momentum they built up in the locker room during halftime. So game plan, it's in the garbage. Time to try something new in this one.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 43 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
The duo of Aaron Jones and A.J. Dillon split the work in Green Bay last season. Jones was still his excellent self with almost 1,400 all-purpose yards and 10 touchdowns. Even moved into the all-time top five for the pocket rushing. No small feat with that franchise's history.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Ball at the 9 on 2nd and 8. Again, it's Jones. No, bottled up. Fumble. It's out. It's loose. Could have been a costly mistake, but as it turns out, they keep possession.
You can't give away these types of opportunities in the red zone. And I'm sure that was flashing through his brain as the ball escaped his hands. Fortunately for him, able to get picked up by his team. Fumble recovered. They still have an opportunity deep in the red zone.
The kicker here, it's complete. And he will not be able to get the first as he can get this only down to the 5. So now on 4th down, Rodgers will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try. The kick by Crosby is good, and that will extend their lead even further. But whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin the second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Give you something to build on for your next possession.
And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Now we're still in the 3rd quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
On 2nd down, here's Barkley. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 1st down for the Giants as they pick up 12.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
So a solid run by Saquon Barkley, and another 1st and 10 here. Off the play fake. Jones. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make 2nd down, 2nd and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 17 yards and a Giant 1st down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that 1st half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there, just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him. His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his 1st read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Steps away to his left. That ball caught by Slayton. Touchdown, Giants!
Darius Slayton, 37 yards. And the Giants are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago.
When? Come on.
He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Yeah, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. There's Jones on third down. This one goes out wide for Barkley. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
We can make this one pretty simple. Walk the ball as progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. And how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down before it's a fourth down?
Gano's kick is good, and that will cut the lead down to 3 scores at 24. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on. Probably say we should have done better there.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. Gets past one man. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. 3 quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Second down and 8. Now to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Schwartz. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 29-yard line. They got 29 yards that time. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Over here, but they're about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all.
And he loses the football a second time. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
Do you remember in preseason when we were going to the different training camps and visiting teams, and we always would see the running backs working out and going through those gauntlet drills, yep. And, you know, guys either slapping at the ball or the machines. You got to learn to take care of it.
Yeah, they lost it there. Big fumble. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Barkley inside handoff. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Jones now to throw on third down. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to bend.
And now here's another interception. A great pick, nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind. Going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
A little jet sweep to start the drive. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Christian Watson, his first rushing touchdown of the year. And the Packers are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. Well, Charles, they had the comfortable lead, and now it's even more comfortable. Another score here in the fourth quarter to grow that lead.
But I think your initial reaction is surprise when you see a team piling it on this late in the blowout. But there are plenty of coaches who also think that if you pull up completely and stop trying to play the game, it shows disrespect to their opponent. So they don't want to embarrass them. They continue to let their players go for it.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds. They've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This will use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three out of it.
And my goodness, another interception. Grady Williams picks it off. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. Well, they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road and help seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
And they'll indeed take a knee. Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. And they take a knee. And now can they reverse the trend on third and goal with the last two plays having gone backwards? And they will take a knee here. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Will give way to Mason Crosby for the field goal try from 28 yards out. The kick by Crosby is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, ultimately not really sure that they're going to need those 3 points, but they'll take the three and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually clicked him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays and trying to add to this lead.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. But we said it at halftime that they would need a nearly perfect second half to erase that deficit that they were facing, CD. But unfortunately, the second half has pretty much been a carbon copy of the first.
Yeah, that early lead was almost insurmountable the way their opponent was playing. They do have some good news, though. This one is getting close to being over, and they can try and hit the reset button starting tomorrow.
Second and six, just inside the 30. To throw. Jones. That'll be caught by Tony. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. This run defense has been pretty stout all game long. Now you're here in the fourth quarter. Rely more on the passing attack?
I don't think you have any choice, and I don't think you have to dress it up at all either. Throughout the first three quarters, you're still trying to convince the defense that you may run the football. That's out the window right now. Protect, let your quarterback operate, and try and find some targets in the open field downfield.
Looking to throw on second down. Jones. That'll be taken in there by Kenny Galladay. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 44-yard line. 19 yards that time for number 19. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score.
To school here, Charles, on a play like that, pretty successful RPO. What's the quarterback looking at?
Basics, he's looking at the defensive end or the outside linebacker. If that player crashes down to take the running back, quarterback pulls it, runs to the outside end. Some teams, though, will read different players depending on defenses, but basically, it's that outside player.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So the completion good for just three. And that's going to bring up second down.
Yeah, that one was covered pretty well because they were trying to leak the tight end out into the flat. I think they were hoping he could catch and turn upfield and pick up the first down.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jones. And now here's another interception. And the Packers are going to get the football here at their own 23. CD, this defense, man. At this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Second down, another shot for Jones. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. There's Rodgers to throw. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they stop him with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Here's Jackson. Big kick that time, 52 yards. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest.
Hold it down! Go, take it to the house.
Here we go. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here on this one, Charles. What's the message? And my goodness, another interception. Adrian Amos with a pick. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. He'll take this to the 46. Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends, and understandably so. Not only did they get the
Yo, the Buffalo Bills are putting the NFL on notice right now. Their defense is amazing. I dropped it! I need the Vikings to win. Are you playing ranked games, bro? What league are you playing in? Let's see what's going on. The guards are broke, man.